how to use the Ajax drop-down helper. Let's start by creating a new project. ASP.NET MVC web application. Let's name it Ajax drop-down tutorial. I'm going to put it on my desktop. Okay. Select an empty project template. VEngine Razor. And okay. Now we need to reference the Awesome library. You can download it from asp.awesome.com. I'm also going to put a direct link into the description of this video. So I've downloaded it already. I'm not missing yet. So I'm going to copy this into my solution. Okay, let's create a lib folder for the Awesome library. Put it in here. Okay. Ajax drop-down tutorial content themes. I'm going to copy the start theme in here. Okay. And the script. Now we can add it in Visual Studio. Let's show all the files. Okay, include the project, the CSS files, and include the JavaScript files. And the reference to our library. Okay, lib, awesome MVC. Now, if we can look on the learn page installation, we have to add in our site master, or in our case layout, CSHTML. We have to add the CSS and the JavaScript files, as well as the jQuery and jQuery UI. So I'm just going to copy this example from here. Copy this and put it in my layout. Use shared layout CSHTML. So jQuery is already referenced, but I'll delete this line because I have it in the code that I've just copied. So, okay. This is the CSS files and the JavaScript files. jQuery, jQuery UI, and Awesome. Now let's try and use the Ajax drop-down helper. First we're gonna need to add the controller, home controller, call it home. So add the view, and the index view, eraser, okay. So in order to use an Awesome helper, we just type HTML. Oh. And as we can see, it's red. We have to import the using Awesome MVC in each page that we use these helpers. This is one way. But another way would be to import it for all pages at once. For this, we have to edit the for Razor views. We have to edit the web config inside the views folder, just like here. It for you can see here for Razor views in the views web config and for web form views in the main web config. So let's copy this and put it in here. Save it. Now it works. We don't need to add the using in each page. Ajax drop down. And for the name, let's call it fruit. Let's hear how it works straight away. So we have an Ajax drop-down. Now if we open the Mozilla Firebug plugin and refresh the page, we are going to see an Ajax request that was sent by the Ajax drop-down. can use it multiple times anywhere in our project just by declaring it. I'm going to show you this. So we're going to use a different name. So because of that, let's specify the controller. Frit Ajax dropdown controller. Using. And let's do one more. Fruit 2. is in our view model, view 1, 2, and 3, and also I'm going to add another Ajax dropdown controller for them. I'm going to call it new param Ajax dropdown controller, and we're gonna have a parameter category. This is the parameter that is going to be predefined. I'm going to use it here. Where category equals category ID. And I'll delete this. Okay. So now let's edit our view. Line break here. I'm just going to copy this. Okay, view 1. I'll have to indicate the controller. View param Ajax dropdown controller. And parameter. A parameter named category. So basically we're saying that for categories set the value 1. That's it. New 2 and 3. Category will be 2 and 3. So basically the category parameter will get the value 1, 2 and 3 from here. And for each dropdown. So let's build and see how it works. So here's our dropdowns, and the first one shows only the first category, the second category, and the third, as you can see. And you can look here and see that the category parameter was sent with the value 1. Here and the value 2 and 3. Okay, now another thing that is used quite often is when we have the first option as text not selected or something like this. And in order to do that, all we have to do is basically just add a selectable item and as the first item without value. So we are going to do this. Let's make a list, initialize a list of selectable items. Now, list add new selectable item without value, and for the text I'll write not selected. And I'm also going to add range. All of this. Okay. And return the list. JSON. Okay, let's build and refresh. Okay, we still have them because we refreshed, but if we do this. See, now the first option is not selected, so this is quite easy to do. There is also another helper which is exactly the same like the Ajax dropdown, and this helper is called Ajax radio list. So basically if you want a radio button list instead of a dropdown, just replace the helper. Let's see how it works. So here it is. As you can see, all we've changed is only the helper. very much for watching and goodbye.